Hey guys, welcome to a new video on the Cell Doctor channel. In this video, I'm going to tear down this 12-volt battery. It's 200 amp hour battery, and the client was claiming that that's not really keeping the charge too much. I took the battery and tested it for capacity, charged it and fully discharged it using a West Mountain testing device. I'll probably make a video in the future to show you that process as well, but you can see it's 12 volts 200 Ah, and that's 2560 watt hour. The good thing is that it was spot on, guys. It was 198. But the client has some consumers on his RV and he was not keeping it charged, and when he needed it, it was not charging fast enough from the car or from the solar panel he has on top. And for that reason, he thought that the battery is dead. So while I still have this battery, I want to tear this down and see what's inside, what kind of cells have been used in this battery, and check the voltage on each cell to make sure it's fully balanced. My guess is that all the cells are balanced because it gave the right capacity, but who knows. Let's check to see if we can disassemble this easily. I noticed that it has some screws on the side for the lid. This is a deep cycle battery. It's made for solar panels. It says on the label that it's a lithium phosphate battery. So we should see some prismatic cells inside. Some 200 amp hour cells. If they didn't put like 100 amp cells in parallel, then serious. But we'll find in a second here. I'm also curious what kind of BMS it uses, because it should use a BMS. Otherwise, this can be dangerous to charge. Alright, so I'm going to use two flat screws and try to go around the lid. Put it on the side. So I'm trying to pry with the screwdriver and cut the glue with a cutter. I'm gonna try use this broomstick to make my way through that glue. I need to make to lift it from this side. Thank you. I always try to use non-metallic materials when pushing inside the battery to make sure I don't short circuit it. And this is it. It's on. I thought there might be silicone all around this, and that's why I thought I have to heat up this. It has some trusty foam on the top of the cells. And as you can see, we have eight cells right here. So my assumption is that these are 100 amp cells, which are in parallel then in series. It looks like so. You can see they are in parallel here. Let me bring the camera lower so you can see inside this battery better. So this is how it looks. It has a BMS on the side as well. Let's see if I can see what kind of BMS it is. Yeah, it says that it's 100 amp. At the bottom I see there is like some glue that holds everything together, so getting these cells out would be quite tricky. Let me try to get a photo of what's in there. So this is how it looks inside. I'm going to take my multimeter and do some measurements now and see if these cells are spot on voltage. Let's put it here. I'll start from this side. It should be negative. So 3.56. And these are in parallel. 357. 334. So this cell is a bit low. So the BMS is not doing a great job balancing these cells. But still, it had a good capacity discharging it to 12. Yeah, it was 12.5, I think. Yeah, so one cell, it's a bit low. To solve this issue, this cell could be charged independently to balance it to the same voltage these cells have. So that will be until there's no current drawn from the power supply, and you set it to 3.65 volts to fully charge it. I will fully charge every cell like I did in one of my previous videos when I repaired an e-scooter battery. Those were unbalanced as well, so that's the way you could fix this, assuming that the cells are not damaged and they don't seem to be having any swelling or sign of being damaged. The screws look to be tightened properly. There's balancing wires coming from each cell. And that's it, guys. I'm going to balance this cell using some alligator clips. I will fully charge all of the cells independently to make sure they are in a good condition and return this battery to the client. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions about this battery or that's related to batteries or testing these out, don't hesitate to comment on this video. Subscribe if you like this kind of content and you want me to keep working on this kind of batteries, and don't forget to visit deepcyclepower.com. Thanks again for watching, and I see you in the next video. All the best.